Yeah, we are in UFA Studios, in the studios of Tanzfabrik, and I'm here in a small residency for 2 weeks before the premiere of the new thing I'm going to do and present within the program Tanznacht. I remember Larry Bott moved to live in London, and I moved there in 1999. And there was a constellation of choreographers that were starting to be like icons of the conceptual dance, like Xavier Llegom, among others. No? But these two are kind of very known in the market of conceptual dance. So they were kind of a family of friends, and then we were working with each other. Like many performers of them, they were performing with the others at the same time. No, I was working, I remember, with 5 choreographers in the 99-2000, going from one project to another, and going from Paris to Berlin. So there was this kind of family is not the right name, but a constellation between colleagues of work, but a strong colleagues. It's not like you don't know each other. Little by little, we knew each other, and we were working with each other for a long time. So when I arrived to Berlin, I was part of this scene, we can say, and I was working a lot with all of them. And then I didn't feel like Berlin like a place for conceptual dance, but I felt the market in Europe started to open up to this new thing, no? New thing for dance. And I think Berlin was particularly interesting because not the conceptual dance, but because of the scene in general. Like there was many spaces, many underground spaces also, but this you don't only see in dance, it's also in parties, in visual arts, also in galleries. How was before Berlin and how it is now, it changed completely, no? Like Berlin now is a very touristic place, and culturally I think it's very touristic also. There is a strong entities in Berlin still, but I think we miss a little bit this kind of underground scene that was happening. And the conceptual dance, even if it became big and strong, but I remember people screaming to us, like people going on stage, pushing us, you know, like we were the freaks of dance, and dance was conservative, also some audiences. So they were a little bit against whatever changed. So I don't remember like conceptual dance at the beginning as something really strong, like now we are here. No, we had to fight in order to be free to express in that way. No? I think this label has been good in a small scene, like small theaters that really bet for these kind of things, for this kind of change or new understanding, new perspective of dance. And this create like a small net of theaters, let's call it more experimental, that they open for more experimentation. And this was good, I think, very good. In another hand, I think commercially is hard, because then we became, I mean, not everybody in the scene, because we know the icons, I think they are in the big theaters, so no problem. But for many of us that we are not icons, let's say, then we became like a ghetto also, like the experimentals or the people that are, you know, questioning or whatever. And this is always a pain in the ass, because in the end you cannot access to the normal way of normal audiences or bigger audience, and there is no parallel work to make this work understandable to others, when sometimes it's even more accessible than a contemporary dance choreography. No, but so in the end, you can profit. I think we all profit, because it's not that you identify, because I don't like neither, and I think nobody likes to be called you are part of a conceptual dance, because you arrive to that, you don't pre-think I want to do conceptual dance. You do what you have to do, and then somebody says this is conceptual dance. So in the end, this identification is kind of somebody invented for you.
Andrea Lepecki has played a big role. Also.
Yeah, Andrea is one of the names that play a super big role.
And this famous book, you are one of the chapters. Huh?
Yeah, he used one of my pieces to develop his thinking about it. It's not a time the chapter. It's not about Juan Dominguez, but he used my work to to develop the thinking, no? Which is funny because I'm not a person that tour a lot, very little. But I'm very known. Sometimes I go to a place because they read the book and it's like, you are Juan Dominguez, but they never saw my work, or it's this kind of unbalanced proportion. Yeah, it's funny. Well, this I have to say, yes. This I have to say, that mostly all the choreographers I know are fucking disaster in management, no? Understanding management. And also, it's not only understanding, it's that many of them, or many of us, we don't want to understand. We don't fucking care. And it's very strange. It's a pity in a way, because I think we could play another role in the field if we would have this desire. But probably because of our culture or something like that. Yeah, in the end, it's skills, because it's something you don't do it because it's boring or it's not interesting, and then you are more focused in something else and not in the whole, because we are a whole structure. We are not only the work, the content. No, everything starts to be together, no? And in this scene, you play a role, and the role has to be played in all the sides, no? Otherwise, it will not work as good as for the others, no? Yeah, it's an average of a good level of understanding the whole apparatus, no? This icon thing, or what you represent as a figure in the field, I don't feel it anymore. And the choreographers I'm in relation to right now, I don't see it as an ambition to become one, to become the artist. We are artists, we know that, and what we want is things to happen and to build a context. And I think people are really looking for another kind of more parallel structures, where is the work what is important. Of course, people are important, we are important, and we are figures, but not figures that need to be figures. It's figures because we are singularities that needs to be there and to be, to affirm themselves, but in another way, I think. And then you see that you can affect through the market, you can affect the audiences with the work, because I think it's what we finally want, not to affect with our work. To success with your work, you spend all your time. This is clear. I see all of us hyper busy to make a career, not to become something, but to make the career. I mean, to make it profitable, in order that your work produce in income for you to live in a minimum of comfortability. No? Because to suffer from the work, we do, and there is many people that they don't care and they will suffer, but it's more important the work than whatever comfortability. But I think for me there is an average. I don't like to suffer to produce the work. I like to have a minimum of conditions. But of course, when you are so busy, there is no time for, as you say, for something else, something that can be thought in another way. And I think we are goal-orientated and product-orientated in this society, not only in art, but in everything, in every aspect. And this is very problematic, because it's only one choice you have. But it's very complex to get rid of that, because, our work is very complex, and then you have to study a lot, you have to go through many things to be able to produce, in the end, this. And this also takes time, so I don't think neither that if you don't care about the market, for instance, and you are on your work, you will be able also to be super free to do other things in a communitarian way, no? But I think I miss a lot, more things happening that is not product-orientated. Things where you can go really experience in other ways, and experience not only art or objects, but experience something else, like complicity. For me, it would be an object that I like in art, it would be as important as a complicity that is not graspable at all. And I don't see, but I feel it, and I invest time on it. So this, I think, complicity as one example, as many others, I think, that are possible to experience and to practice reality and life. No? I mean, we live in such a dynamics that it's very complex to use solidarity or to use engagement in other things that are not the ones that make you survive, and it's already quite hard, no? I'm very interested because of the difficulties of getting complicity with in a community or in a, I don't know, community if it's the right word, but in the spectrum of society, within art particularly, no? I think complicity has something good in relation to you don't need to identify with a community or a blah, blah, and you don't need to agree. You can work in disagreement and identification, we don't care, you don't care. It's more about, okay, there is complicity to work in something, and then there is an energy there that we can transform in work and produce something. So complicity for me sometimes, I'm trying to understand, because to propose complicity, how you could propose this complicity, because complicity as such is great. So we don't need to, it's fantastic when you have complicities, there is no doubt, but how to propose that. And then there is all this kind of, you have to seduce people, you have to. So there is where I have a lot of resistance now, like to continue producing sexy apparatus and erasing a little bit of content and putting more importance in the apparatus, like the how. And the how, I was working a lot in the last few years in the how we talk, how we build things. So the meta theater experience, no? Because I also think it's very important, the how. But in another hand, it can cover, can hide a lot of the content. So I like a lot that the content is also very visible right now. And that's why I prefer in the past 6 years I was working a lot also with surprise, with like things that suddenly let you in a small sort of circuit and get very attractive, no? And now I would like to be more rough, you know, like there is no attractive. I mean, there is attraction to things, but I like really more like flat and straight things, like, and then it's really like, really? Do we have to deal with this? Yes, we have to. So how complicity can play a role into this roughness, no? So then it becomes also the word compromise, and so a lot of concepts also that I think ethically we have to really highlight right now more than to, yeah, more than to please the desires of your desires and the desires of somebody else. It's more like this is it, how we can make it. Of course, conspiracy is a very nice word or concept to think, to think in a more perverse way. I mean, if we cannot be good, let's play bad, no? And let's subverse and try to be transgressive. But not the transgression, the radical transgression, like a super punk or whatever. No, it's something more subtle, you know, and more, okay, this way, here. And then to try to really to make things no matter what. So don't wait for permission, don't wait for instance, lately I say a lot this, who is allowing us to be artists lately is academia, no? There is a lot of power from academia, from the critics that say this is it, this is not, no? And also play roles in names and blah, blah. And this becomes super important. It's like, well, okay, if this is the game, which I don't think somebody's deciding on purpose, or maybe yes, this could be interesting to spy, no? But in another hand, it's like we cannot wait for the permission of academia. We cannot wait for any authority to do our work. We have to do it. So let's find a way of doing it without any permission. So this is for me an interesting concept about conspiracy, no? It's a very difficult subject, how political are you in your work, because in one hand, whenever you want to be political, you get like a struggle in this ambition, and then for me sometimes it frees me more than allowed me, but then then I understand this picaresca as a way, not only as a way of doing my way under the, you know, undercover, but more like trying to propose this as a strategy that we share, also curators and institutions. Yeah, also, but not alternative. This is a big. It's because I'm very tired of looking for alternatives. Mm-hmm. So it would be more like it's another way. It exists and I'm using it. And it's another way. It's not an alternative to that. Because then it becomes political. It's reacting, it's resisting. And this, I'm very tired of it. Although I think I will never stop resisting things, because ethically, I mean, we are also ethic units. And we try to live our lives in a coherent way, no? But it's like, okay, no, this is another possible way, and I'm here now. And the rest, I have to build a space for this to happen. And this is my politics. More than I'm building this to resist or to, these motherfuckers, no. Of course there is motherfuckers, and there is, there is capitalism, but how to find your space is to create in the space. And then you have to find, and you have to really find how to create your space. And when I say your, of course, start from me, because the needs and the ambition comes start from me, but there are others with their ambitions. So maybe we can be a cross where we suddenly, we are a group in the same, or a lot of people in the same needs, even if it's temporarily. So let's use that energy, you know, to... The bizarre aspects of what we can become, or how we can become, how bizarre we can become, because I don't think we are so bizarre, but we can be seen as bizarre because maybe we are not so conventional than others, is something that... I mean, it's like you say, when a species is disappearing, I think it's a huge loss. No, like every subtle distinction is super important to enrich our perception, our culture, everything. No, in life, sometimes it's also nice that there is no, that is less rich and it's more simple, and then you can not get crazy with that. I think society, in that sense. Is teach to become very simple, but that's why it's not that I'm against simplicity, but I think complexity is also very important. And then context of complexity, or bizarre, let's call it however, but that ask for more commitment to engage on it or not, are super important. And then this is what I said before. I think they have to happen anyway. If maybe there is not a good moment for institutions or for a market to support it, they have to happen in another way. And I think the other way is simply thinking into them. Because the problem, I think, is we don't think anymore in this kind of context. We accept too much what is there, you also get very tired of fighting, no? And then in the end, it's like, okay, I do my small thing, and if I do my small thing and I'm capable of doing it, then it's fair enough. But I think this is a pity. I was good, it's fair enough, but it's not enough neither. So I think we have to produce it. We have to sit together and then think together. And I don't think we have to identify really with each other, because then it's going to be impossible. But in certain moments, I think we could be more supportive and go for things like, okay, I mean, if I don't like the work of Diego, who cares? I mean, we are working here and then we produce a situation and that's it. It's not about me in relation to you. It's more about in relation to the other thing. And yeah, probably it's this. We have to do more in that sense.